The mystery man came over and he said, I'm out of sight. He said, for a nominal service charge, I could reach Nirvana tonight. If I was ready, willing, and able to pay him his regular fee, he would drop all the rest of his pressing affairs and devote his attention to me. But I said,
ooh, dear brother, were you driving with the cosmic debris?
Now who are you driving with that cosmic debris? The mystery man got nervous and he fidgeted around a bit. He reached in the pocket of his mystery robe and he whipped out a shaving kit. Now I thought it was a razor and a can of foaming goo. But I told him right then when the top popped open, there was nothing his box won't do. With the oil of Aphrodite and the dust of the Grand Wazoo, he said, you might not believe this little fella, but it'll cure your asthma too. And I said, hey,
who dear brother, who you talking to that caused me to bleed?
Now what kind of a guru are you anyway? I said, and you can't help me out. So take your meditations and your preparations and cram it up your snout. He said, held it on up to the light. So I snatched it all away from him, and I showed him how to do it right.
I wrapped the newspaper around my head, so I looked like I was deep. Said some mumble jumbles then. I told him he was going to sleep. I wrapped his ring in his pocket watch and everything else around. Shit, I had that sucker hypnotized. He couldn't even make a sound. I proceeded to tell him to shoot him in. As long as he was hanging around, I said,
the price of meat has just gone up and your old lady has just gone down. Now is that a real poncho or is that a Sears poncho? Don't you know? You can make more money as a butcher. So don't you waste your time on me.